To the gym's food court, beef stew, scalloped potatoes, vegetables, sweet potato. We got it all here. They got it all.
Africa, what are you getting? What are you gonna get from the food court?
Some healthy good stuff.
Peach Squad. Let me set up the camera real quick. Peach Squad. So we are here at the gym's food court, Africa. Is gonna eat before the workout.
Like
when we work out early in the morning, I don't really like to eat anything. I like to work out on an empty stomach, but she's so much different than I am. You know, everyone's different. And what I'm trying to get to is that you have to find things that work for you if you want to achieve this goal of yours. You know, because this is a lifestyle. This is not a one-time thing. So you have to find things that work for you, and everybody's so much different. Everybody's body is different. You know, it's like a mental thing too. You don't want to be so strict on your diet. Like Africa, she eats good food all the time. She got some beef stew, scalloped potatoes, vegetables. Like me, I probably would have got chicken breast. I would have got scalloped potatoes too, some pasta. You know, and one thing I don't want you guys to have stuck in your head is the word diet. You know, you don't want to think of it as a diet. You want to think of just eating healthier, making healthier food choices that are gonna stick with you for the rest of your life. You know, because if you constantly think diet and you restrict yourself for periods of time, it's only gonna lead to binge eating in the future. You know, so, you know, I've been doing this for a long time. A lot of you just start working out. Trust me, you have no idea what I'm talking about. If you really wanna do this, you have to just get in the mindset of it, making it a healthy lifestyle. Don't think of it as a diet. That's the last thing you want to do. Just don't ever think of diet. Just think of it healthy lifestyle, and you're gonna be okay, because a lot of you are just getting into this fitness journey and you're thinking that, and you're seeing all these other people tell you what to eat, right? Like, oh, just eat brown rice, don't eat white rice. You know, they tell you all these foods that you should only eat, and you will see results, don't get me wrong, but they don't take into account the long-term damage it does to you. You know, what I'm trying to prevent you guys from doing is like just long-term damage, you know, binge eating, unhealthy food habits. Just make it a lifestyle, eat some good food, and you're gonna be okay.
Man, baby, you eat some good food.
Yes, I am, baby.
Hey, eating food like this though, it makes it a lot easier for you, huh? To like enjoy working out. Imagine you couldn't eat any of this. Imagine that.
We always look at our Snapchat of like things that we were doing last year, and I brought Africa here to Equinox to play some basketball, and look how small she is. Yo, look how small she is back then compared to now. Oh, she ain't skinny no more. Ooh, girl. Damn, baby. Popping. Look at this. Damn, Africa, you're so much different now.
Legs are growing. Arms are growing. I don't know why it's so blurry. Ooh, back is popping.
It wasn't back then though. So something me and Africa have seriously been thinking about doing is hiring a chef to make us food. You know, like maybe like two meals a day, not like a chef that lives and stays in our house, but like a chef that cooks like two meals a day for us. Because, you know, back then we couldn't afford a chef. Now that we could afford a chef to cook us healthy food, why wouldn't we do it? You know, it's just like, it's gonna save us a lot of time. And obviously there's so many foods that we can't even think of or cook that this chef is gonna make for us. It's just gonna make our lives so much easier, and it's just gonna make our day better because we're gonna have so much better food to eat.
Healthy food.
And everybody knows good food equals a good life.
What do you think about the chef?
I think it's a perfect idea. I think a lot of people think that chefs are expensive, but you have to really think that, like, if you're always eating out and always busy and always on the go, like me and Anthony, we're always productive, we're always busy, we're always at the gym, we're always on the run. I think a chef will actually save us so much money and time, and I'll get thicker, Anthony will get slimmer, more ripped, or whatever his goal is, and ultimately it'll be a lot healthier because we've been looking at this one specific chef He cooks everything organic, even if it's like a sauce or anything off from scratch. Even if it's ice cream, it's from scratch or like whatever he cooks. And
ooh, ice healthy. Cream.
Yeah, and he cooks it with organic, low fat, and stuff like that. So anything that you basically decide to eat, it's so much healthier. And we spend so much money.
Like, I'm just excited. Point is, I'm excited for food.
I'm excited. I love food. I used to not really like food, and now I love food. Like, this beef stew is the bomb.
So I just got home. And guess what came in the mail? Ooh, I wonder what it is. So here it is. I gotta cover my address because I get so many comments, people telling me that I show my address in my videos too many times, you know? And one of my videos got like 2 million views. I guess my address was shown on there, but oh well. I guess y'all know where I live. Let's see what this is. I'm pretty sure you guys know. I mean, I'm pretty sure. It's what it is. I think it is. Does that even make sense? I think I know what it is, what I think it is. Okay. Keys it is. Okay. I really hope I open this correctly because I feel like I'm going to rip the box off the wrong way. Oh, I'm so excited. You know what? Peace Squad, before I open this, whatever it is, I just want to give a shout out to y'all because I wouldn't be making YouTube videos if it wasn't for your constant support, always commenting on my videos, you know? When you guys comment on my videos, it lets me know that you guys are engaged, you guys are liking the videos, so thank you very much. And it is what I thought it was going to be, my little plaque. A little plaque. Oh, light. Yeah, I got it. A little plaque.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I know.
That's so cool.
I know. Victoria's happy for me, I think. Right?
Yeah, I am. Okay.
Shit, look at this.
Yo, that's so sick.
For 100,000 subscribers.
Aww.
You know, I had like 130, and I didn't know. I thought YouTube was just going to send it to me automatically.
Yeah.
And someone kept telling me, like, hey, have you got your plaque yet? I'm just like, no. So on YouTube, I'm like, how do I claim my plaque? I guess I had to like do something on the YouTube thing. Because
oh,
I was just waiting for them to send it to me.
Oh, you didn't even know.
So right now I'm like at 139,000. So I should have got it like a long time ago, but.
That's so cool.
Here it is, guys. This is our plaque, Peace Squad. You know what's cool? It has these things right here so I can hang it on the wall.
Aww.
You know, Tony!
He's famous! The booty king is famous.
Right here. No, I don't know where to hang it. Maybe my room, huh?
Or no, right there.
But their living room?
No, right here.
Yeah.
So people when they come over, they can see it.
You could just like set it up. Just like made it.
Like, you think it'll look good here?
No. Yeah. Yeah, because when you get your million subscribers, once you get your million subscriber plaque, you can put it next to it.
I guess I don't gotta hang it.
Yeah, just for now.
Gray's gonna see that and just be like, drop it. Okay, so before I end this video, does anybody have any questions? Me, Mr. Booty King. Any questions? Me, Mr. Booty King. Me! So, first of all, my name's Stacy, guys. Stacy. So my question to you, Mr. Booty King, is like, I feel like my booty is a stubborn muscle. Like, I struggle so much to feel the booty. Like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong, Mr. Booty King. Like, I'm squatting low, I'm squeezing the booty, and I squat. I'm deadlifting, and I squeeze the booty, but I don't feel the booty. Like, what do I do? What am I doing wrong in my leg day? I don't get it. Stubborn glutes, you say. Well, I actually have a solution for that. You know, I just finished training my client. Let me show you exactly how you can fix that.
All right, triple drop set. We got stubborn glutes. Here it is. So we're gonna do 12 reps with this weight. Right after that, I'm gonna take 10 pounds off. She's gonna do 12 more. And then I'm gonna take it off 10 more, and then she's gonna do as many as she could. All out right here, triple drop set. Squeeze those glutes at the top. All right. Let's go. as many as you could, okay? Say to Peach Squad,
never stop.
Never stop.
Most trainers will always tell you, start with compound lifts before you move on to like glute isolation exercises or band work or cable exercises or like single leg work, right? They always tell you that. You know, they're not wrong if your goal is to build overall strength. But what if your goal is to build the glutes and that's all you really care about? That's all you care about.
Glutes. Wow, I didn't know that.
You start with glute isolation. You start with glute isolation exercises. You know, what that's gonna do is gonna tear up all the muscle fibers in that muscle, and it's gonna have better muscle recruitment when you move on to compound lifts like squats, lunges, or deadlifts.
Oh, wow.
You know, because they've been worn out already. Trust me, just do the pre-exhaust method and you'll be okay, Stacy. Okay, Beach Squad, I think I'm done here. Today's video's over, but I wanna thank you guys again. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have that 100k plaque. I wouldn't be making these videos if it wasn't for you guys, and hope you guys enjoyed the video. And remember, pineapple belongs on pizza.